For Cameron Deber, high-rise building is incompatible with creating a humane community. Therefore, in Shushtar Newtown, he used a low-rise dwelling type inspired by the traditional architecture of Shushtar. Plot sizes are identical and measure 180 square meters, with few exceptions to create smaller houses at the end of some blocks. All types of dwellings have a courtyard that functions as an open-to-the-sky room and reflects the cultural identity of Iranians. As in a typical courtyard house, the inhabitants can move around the courtyard to avoid or welcome sunshine. In each of the houses, two zones with different privacy levels coexist: the private familial area, the Andaruni, and the area reserved for exterior social relations, the Biruni. These zones are linked through the courtyard. Contrary to the Western notion of the house as an agglomeration of different rooms with particular functions, such as living room, dining room, or bedroom, in Shushtar, the concept of the room as a flexible unit was used. Relatively large multi-purpose rooms enclose the courtyard and are potentially divisible. They size an average of 5 by 5 meters, fitting the Iranian way of life. And moreover, all dwellings have a roof terrace for sleeping. The uncomfortable stigma of low-income housing has been avoided by the provision of units that are able to accommodate growth through time. Neighbouring dwellings also allow for eventual combining units into bigger dwellings. In this way, economic, social, and architectural growth is accommodated within the existing fabric. The massing of each of the living quarters is a parallel arrangement clustered along narrow streets following the traditional models of Iranian architecture. Because of the east-west orientation of the streets, the houses face either south or north, which is an orientation that helps shading and allows the houses to catch the prevailing north wind. The back-to-back rows of houses are placed in a rectilinear pattern for a rational installation of infrastructure, but different planned irregularities, such as difference in street levels, setback of facades, and first floors bridging over the street, break up the monotony of repeating units. A private sense of public space is created in front of the dwellings, where the houses literally meet the street. This realm is the intermediate space between private and public, and can be seen as an extension of the dwelling, where children play and parents chat and interact with the neighbours. From here, the narrow, treeless, brick-paved streets lead to transversal alleys which open up for small squares and playgrounds and eventually lead to the lively, verdant spine.